story of the perfect amplifier. The audio amplifier has some magic attraction to DIY audience and engineers who are trying to make a perfect unit since I remember it. In consumer shows, we can see large variations of power amplifiers in size, power, dimensions, and design. Is it possible to make perfect amplifier for everybody? In this video, I will cover the complete design process of how to develop a perfect amplifier aiming exceptionally to sound quality. This video is just another story about how to build a perfect amplifier, where I will cover analysis of each critical component involved, chosen amplifier architecture, sales and marketing strategy for product commercialization, slightly touching such a sensitive topic as human beliefs and expectations, as well as make short competitor analysis. How does it start? Sometimes small things are making large impact. After I published my first amplifier design story, one of the YouTube listeners, Roberto, put a short comment asking how to improve my DIY design by adding good preamplifier circuit. This short message triggered an idea to build a perfect amplifier meeting most demanding audiophile requirements, at the same time keeping costs reasonable. The open question was, is it possible to commercialize such a design? Actually, it's not a simple question. There are so many good designs out in the market. But everything is possible when we are focused and apply a systematic approach. My first step was understanding target audience, in my case, people who value high quality audio. Then study competitors and understand the market. In simple words, I need to do serious market research to find out where is the place for my new design idea. I did two parallel studies, the audiophile market and the professional market. Some of my findings I will share with you in the following slides. Audiophile world. When you are talking about perfect amplifier, you need to drill down and understand what meaning is behind it. Audiophile world and high-end audio is a very sensitive audience where many opinions and decisions are not 100% rational. I would compare it with people who believe in something. If you look back to history, people's beliefs always were strengthened with sacrificing something. Inca people in South America sacrificed children believing that it will bring them better life. Catholic Church demands priests to give up family. Aztecs has a bloody ritual sacrificing animals and human lives. When we do such sacrifice, our way back is really hard, or in reality, almost impossible. When I drilled down in hi-fi and high-end audio topics, I was surprised about the prices and mounted jewelry type of equipment with massive golden-plated knobs, heavy metal parts, and super nice-looking front panels. Does it improve the sound? No, this is sacrifice. Audiophile community sacrifices the money. Most of audiophile market dedicated products are heavily overpriced. Even a simple film capacitor is covered with golden rings and terminals, being 10 times overpriced to mainstream products. But any engineers know those good capacitors are produced in a few large factories. The technology process is expensive and the price is a matter of economy of scale. Nothing will change in parameters when you finally put some of those units in golden plated plastic cover and trade it with a multiplier of 10. It is a million words question. What the audiophile community is looking for. Is it audio quality or something else? Even today, after studying tons of forums, I don't have the answer to that. But if you talk about a real audiophile, you will meet rational and irrational combination, where the most dogmatic statement is following. In a music production, there are things that humans can hear, but engineers can't measure. This is a moment where I would argue that human hearing is far from the perfect instrument, heavily impacted by brain activity. We do have a powerful digital sound processor in our head that we can tune by our consciousness and compensate shortfalls of sensors. If we want to hear something and focus on that, after some time our brain will create it. Let us take a simple example. We want to record nice spring singing birds. We take a tour to nearest riverside, there are a lot of birds. We record them with a good microphone and recorder. Going home and playing back on a large speaker, we are surprised to hear river water passing under the bridge, running highway, and by the way, there are birds somewhere in the background. In the moment of recording, our consciousness gave a signal to hear birds, and DSP processed it accordingly. At the riverside, we want to hear the birds and brain activity focused on the task. This is the reason why blind listening tests frequently give unexpected results. Today, engineers are capable to measure any aspect of audio. If you are adding superior element in your system and not able to measure impact and output, but hear an improvement, there is only two explanations. Either you don't know how to measure it, or it's just a placebo effect done by brain DSP. Unfortunately for us, marketing found it out and created an elite club named High-End Audio, where the sky is the limit of pricing and fancy designs. In this video, I will show a complete path to perfect audio amplifier, where each component and engineering decision will have a proof, answers and explanation how it will impact the end result. My ultimate goal is to make a perfect power amplifier covering 95% of audiophile and professional application needs. Why not 100%? The last 5% of quality is very expensive, and honestly say I'm not sure that I do have the necessary knowledge and resources to cover it. For those who are ahead of market with research and development department like IcePower and Hypex, and we will learn from them and be one of the first implementing new discoveries in our designs.